The Philippine government's food stamp program launches today, starting with 50 families from Tondo, Manila. Philippine Social Welfare Chief Rex Gachalian says the department will pilot the program for 6 months. The initial beneficiaries have been identified using the targeting system of the Social Welfare Department. Now, the recipients will be using electronic benefit transfer cards with credits loaded monthly worth 3,000 pesos, which can only be used with partner merchants. The value loaded in the card cannot be withdrawn or converted into cash. The stage is set for the signing of the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund Bill in Malacañang today. Critics, though, are still voicing their concerns in a latchless attempt to stop the MIF from being established. Lady Vicentio has more.
The Maharlika Investment Fund has drawn mixed reactions since its inception last year. The MIF, which will have an authorized capital of 500 billion pesos, will be managed by the Maharlika Investment Corporation and will be used for various investments. Despite its earlier version drawing criticisms from several lawmakers, economists, and other groups, the bill hurdled Congress after it was certified as urgent by President Marcos Jr. in May. Capital funds for the MIF will come from the dividends of the Banco Central ng Pilipinas and other government financial institutions. 50 billion pesos will come from the Land Bank of the Philippines and 25 billion pesos from the Development Bank of the Philippines. The Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation will also contribute to the fund. State Pension Funds Social Security System, or SSS, and the Government Service Insurance System, or GSIS, among others, were removed as sources of capital funding following public backlash. Some economists have also raised concerns over the creation of the MIF.
Diversion of earnings from the national government as a source of funding. That the earnings from such entities as the Banco Central, PAGCOR, etc., and even proceeds from privatization, all form part of current government revenues that potentially finance the budget under the one fund concept. Rather than spending revenue for current expenditures, however, say publicly provided infrastructure and social services, the creation of the Maharlika Fund diverts these revenues in order to form a corporation. The relevant concept is the social rate of time preference. How much of a future return would society be willing to accept in order to postpone using a peso today instead of investing it in a project for some future return? For this is exactly what is being done when we divert revenues that we could have used for current needs and instead set them aside to form a corporation that promises to invest these funds and return more pesos in the future.
But the administration's economic managers have allayed fears linked to the fund, saying the bill has enough safeguards in place. Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno expects the MIF to be operational before the end of the year. He said the bill's implementing rules and regulations is almost ready.
It is my responsibility to make it succeed. And I think that I'm very optimistic because, as I said, we have an array of projects with very high rate of return.
Aside from the MIF, another bill waiting for the president's signature is the estate tax amnesty extension. The bill has been approved in May by both chambers of Congress. It aims to extend the allotted time to file estate tax returns until June 14, 2025, 2 years from the prescribed deadline set by the previous administration. About 920,000 Filipino families with unsettled estate taxes could benefit from the extension. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri said Filipinos who were not able to avail of the amnesty earlier due to the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic will have more time to settle their estate taxes. The bill allows for payment by installment within 2 years from the statutory date without civil penalty and interest. Lady Vicentio, ABS-CBN News.
The camp of embattled Philippine lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr. files a motion to dismiss complaints against him in connection with the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Owen Degamo. Teves was a no-show on the last day of the Justice Department's probe on the murder complaints against him. His camp also did not file a counter affidavit for evidence. For his lawyers, there were no allegations to respond to, as other suspects in the Degamo slay have all recanted their statements, tagging Bevis in the killer.
Una-una, nagrekan po yung mga testigo. Pangalawa, assuming without conceding na walang epekto yung recantation, even in their original statements, wala pong matibay na ebidensya na nagtutuon kay Congressman Teves na siya ang pasimuno ng pagpatay kay Governor Degamo. At pangatlo, ayun nga po, ay yung kanilang statements na yun ay uncounseled.
But Justice Secretary Remulla remains confident authorities still have a strong case against Devens.
Recantations, as I always said, are looked upon with disfavor by the courts and even by the prosecution. Because we know that it is human experience which tells us that recantations are an afterthought after looking at the responsibility attached to what they had done. Marami kami ibang independent evidence. Don't worry, you'll find out later on.
Also on the agenda today, the release of the International Criminal Court's decision on the fate of its probe on the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. While the ruling has yet to be released, the Philippine government asserts it will not implement any arrest warrant should the ICC decide to issue one. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla insists the ICC has no business in the Philippines.
May kanya-kanya pong kampo ang politika na pinaninindigan ng maraming tao. At isa na po yan sa mga dahilan na nakikita namin sa ICC na meron pong political agenda ang mga taong nais makialam sa kalayaan ng Republika ng Pilipinas at sa ating sovereignty. It's a political process already that happened. We are no longer members of the ICC. So my concern is not too much on the ICC.
75% of Filipinos support the country's military partnership with the U.S. in resolving maritime disputes with China. That's according to Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, citing a Pulse Asia survey. Only 14% of the respondents said they are not in favor of stronger ties between Manila and Washington. Now, for Zubiri, data show Filipinos are already fed up with China's incursions into the country's territory. The Senate president also earlier backed a proposal to present the United Nations the repeated violations of China against the 2016 arbitral ruling on the South China Sea. Chinese President Xi Jinping telling former Philippine leader Rodrigo Duterte to continue promoting ties between Manila and Beijing. This after the bilateral relations between the two countries cooled when President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. took office last year, reviving ties with the U.S. Xi and Duterte met at the Daewoo Thai State guest house in Beijing. There, Xi thanked Duterte for his pivot to China during his term as president. Duterte, meanwhile, thanked Xi for China's support in the economic development of the Philippines. There is no information yet on who extended the invitation to Duterte and in what capacity he is representing the Philippines. Senate Deputy Minority Leader Lisa Monteveros, meanwhile, hits what she called the deafening silence of Malacanang on the 7th anniversary of the country's arbitral victory over China. Monteveros noted only the Foreign Affairs Department issued a statement last July 12, celebrating the country's landmark win. She says Malacanang cannot stay mum on the matter, given China's continuing aggression in Philippine waters.
Even if this pivot towards the larger international community is for real, hanggang ngayon, wala pa rin tayong narinig sa presidente na tahasang pagtutol niya sa paulit-ulit na pambabastos ng China sa ating soberanya. Nitong nakaraang linggo lang, ni hindi naglabas ng pahayag ang Malacanang sa anibersaryo ng ating makasaysayang pagkapanalo sa The Hague. Pagkatapos mag-statement ang Chinese Embassy ng kanilang pagbasura sa ating tagumpay sa arbitral ruling, wala man lang kibo ang palaso. The silence is deafening.